All right, so let's talk. Bloodborne, Forbidden Forest sucks. Just throwing that out there. It's too big. The Forbidden Forest is too damn big. And yes, that is what she said. That's what everybody who gone through that damn area say. Damn. Got lost so many times. I turned my ass around like 4 times without even knowing. It was just not a good look on my part. We gonna finally see a Merkava? We finally gonna see a Merkava? So anyway, while we wait for this, hopefully it won't be too long for this spectation to end. I have been progressing fairly well in Bloodborne. I haven't unfortunately had a moment in time where like I could really truly sit down and like dedicate myself to like playing an extended period of time. And so I've just kind of been, you know, playing an hour here, an hour there. But I've gotten through, I think I've beaten 6 bosses now, I wanna say. And obviously, as mentioned, fuck the Forbidden Forest. Why is, oh, I see, Soshido 35 double X was taking forever to get their ass out of that. So we're gonna see it. 35, 33 total. You don't got nothing better to do with your time. I'm not actually judging, like, dude, if you enjoyed every single one of those, that shit was time well spent. But still, goddamn, that's a lot of games played. I'd be really curious. I guess I'll probably have to try and ask the NSA, because I'm sure they know. I'm sure they keep it all in files. Nate Aristotle played online games. Was that the A auto combo? That looked like the A auto combo to me. But this is gonna suck, because this is definitely the first Merkava I've seen. And Merkava seems like the kind of character that is going to kind of bend you over and have his way with you the first time around. Plus the fact that this dude is listed as a 1 bar, I'm not holding high hopes for all of the things. But yeah, shit, what was I talking about for Bloodborne? Oh, right, because I haven't really had time to do much of anything. Because last week was midterms, but now I have spring break. And I haven't told anybody I'm on spring break. So, work shouldn't know, unless they're stalking me. And so hopefully I'll be able to use that time for a variety of things. But largely, bodying some bitches in Bloodborne. But yeah, it would be really interesting to like know exactly how many fights, how many matches I played across all my fighting games. Cause I know I didn't break the 1000 mark in CP for sure. I probably did in CS. Definitely not in any of the other games. What would be... Ultimate Marvel would probably be the biggest one, so I'm definitely not picking her. Alright, let's see how badly we're gonna get bodied. I should actually probably sit up and try to focus for this, since obviously this is not going to be a scrub. Should I start out with Mortal Slide? Should I be YOLO? Nah. Okay, so Mortal Slide definitely didn't win that. That's a crit. That was meant to be 2B, but I fucked up. Damn it. I started blocking overhead, then I stopped blocking overhead. What? Aw, damn. I tried to Grim Reaper there, but obviously Grim Reaper doesn't have any. Let me see if I can get under that. Obviously not. I tried a 3C, in case you were wondering. Why wouldn't that be sick? Ha! Oh, you can fake that shit? That's cool. I blocked that. That's a shame. Double perfected. Awesome. I don't know why I was blocking high that entire time. move did I get? Whatever move I got, I did not mean to get. So that connection, I mean, well, actually, I don't know. It's kind of hard to tell whether or not a connection is good or bad when you get your ass handed to you that badly. This is, I'll stick around in this, but I really hate, this is why I hate, kind of, like, this is why you don't really see me playing fighting games that much when there's only lobbies available. And in every single anime game that has come out, ranked has basically been a wasteland since CP. And I largely attribute that to their new lobby system that they do. But so, like, this shit. Sitting here and having to wait for other people to play, I don't enjoy it. I don't like it. Like, in something like this, I want to play this dude and figure out Merkava and figure out the matchup and figure out when I can press buttons and when I can't, when I should shield, when I shouldn't. All that shit. Everything you need to know for a matchup. I want to be in analytical mode. I can't figure that out when watching somebody else. I really can't. And then also, you have people like this let the timer run down because they're awesome people, I guess. And so it's all just like a waste of time. I don't really care about watching other people play that much. If I'm trying to actually learn something. But nobody ever joins just two-person lobbies. They don't do it. It irritates me. But I never... Every time I have made just a two-person lobby to try to do one-on-one, I have never had anybody join. But then I'll make, you know, like four-plus person lobbies and people will immediately join. Yeah, that's definitely, that's not an overhead that I will be getting hit by once I obviously know what to look for. Because Merkava is absolutely not like, I don't really understand, how do you have fun doing this? I mean, like, he almost double perfected me. All because I pressed two incorrect buttons. Like the first round I got, I can't even remember what I got. Oh, 5B. Instead of 2B. And so I ended up getting bopped for that. But I really just don't understand where the enjoyment comes from. I would never stick around in a lobby like this. Were I any good at this game? Because, like, it's not fun to just annihilate people like he's doing. There is absolutely zero enjoyment to be gotten from it. So, yeah, I don't know. Maybe I should just try to learn Merkava. That's in general the fastest way to understand a character is to pick that character and try to play them. But obviously it takes a hell of a lot more effort to try and pick up a character and play them than it does to try and play against them. But yeah, this game just doesn't have enough of like a population to really be able to try to find like matchup specific people to grind out a matchup against. That was not a good start. Is this Merkava? I really feel like, because I don't know a lot about this game, but from what I am seeing, I really don't feel like this guy is that great. I mean, number one, just the simple fact that I'm fairly certain you're supposed to end in a knockdown. And I have never seen this dude end a single combo in a knockdown. It's not even like he's going for, like, cross under mix up or anything, you know, any kind of gimmicks off of the non-knockdown stuff. He's just not knocking down. Finish your play. That's the number one rule of fighting games. If you can't finish your combos, you may as well not even be here. Alright, so I'll just do this one more match, and then if I end up inevitably getting destroyed again, I'll try and find something else. Because, like, it's not... Again, I don't care about... Oh, maybe... Was it the other dude? Nope, never mind. I don't give a shit about getting annihilated. That doesn't matter to me. Like, I played that Waldstein guy for a while until I started blowing him up with Bordeaux, and I figured out, like, okay, this guy is actually not worth playing. But, I think I'm gonna salt over it. I'm gonna try and assault at the beginning. I mean, the thing you should be doing at the beginning. Try to get under it. Try to get Grim Reaper, but I was too slow. I don't have any reactions right now. Oh, right, grabs happen. I blocked! Alright, okay, alright, fine, fine, fine. The last two times I've been hit both, I don't really understand why. Fuck you. That would've worked too. That was supposed to be C Grim Reaper. Oh well. I mean, three times in a row I got hit because shit I tried to do didn't come out. Oh, I tried the Grim Reaper. My Grim Reapers are just not really working out. Oh, I should not have tried to do that. Grim Reaper, you motherfucker, four times now! God! Okay. Yeah, I mean, right now, I don't know why I'm getting blocked. Dude! Cool. Cool. That is quite literally... six actions in a row that I tried to do that just did not come out. I would understand it if I was doing B Grim Reaper, because B Grim Reaper doesn't have B Grim Reaper doesn't have any invincibility to it. There's no invincibility to that move. So getting beaten out of that would be fine. C Grim Reaper has invincibility. Why is it not fucking coming out? That shit irritates the hell out of me when stuff like that happens. Like, how are you can't... I'm actually gonna go see. Maybe there's people playing ranked. I don't fucking know, but I would much rather be playing... Oops, no, I don't care about that. Great. It's unfortunate that... This is definitely a game that I really want. Oh, I should have stuck around. I'd be playing right now. This is most definitely a game that I really want to play. I want to be able to play it. But the population is just not large enough to support how I want to play. And I'll freely admit, like, it's completely just my own fault for not wanting to sit here and spectate. I don't care about that. In games like BlazBlue, where, like, I'm actually decent at it, games like Marvel, I'm actually, well, not anymore, but games like Marvel, where I was actually decent at it, spectating was fun. That was perfectly fine. But this isn't a game that I want to fucking spectate. This is a game that I want to goddamn well play. And I can't do that when I'm just spectating 80% of the damn time. And that's not, like, the whole thing about how people don't join two-player lobbies. That is not something that is only... that I've only found in this game. It is every single game that I have ever played. It's basically people just do not join two-player lobbies. Because I'll test it out. It's not like there's nobody around and there's nobody to join lobbies, period. I'll test it. And I'll try to make a two-player lobby and I'll sit there for like 10, 15 minutes just doing something else. Maybe I'll read a book. Maybe I'll like, you know, play my Game Boy, do something else, you know, whatever. Game Boy, the Nintendo DS, that's what the kids are calling these days, or the DS. Play the DS, you know, do something else while I'm waiting and just hoping somebody else will join, and nobody ever does. And so then again, like I said, I'll test it. I'll make a four-player lobby, and within like 15 seconds, somebody joins. So it's not like there's nobody around to join, it's just they don't give a shit about trying to play one-on-one. That's not what they're there for, player matches for. So, but that's what I want to be there for. And so the only other one-on-one format available to me is ranked, but nobody fucking plays ranked anymore. And so it definitely is kind of a constant source of annoyance in games like this, where, and this is why, like, the anime community will never really expand. Like, people are always talking about, like, yo, man, you need to help your anime communities grow. You want people to start playing that shit, blah, blah, blah. But nobody sticks with a game. Nobody sticks with a game. People import it, they play it for a couple months. And then there's a couple of months where, you know, it goes away, so people migrate on to another game or something. To the game that just got imported again. And so now this new game that now just came out in America and people are looking into it, trying to find out information for it, they can't find a fucking person playing it because they've all moved on to the new import. Nobody cares about the American release. And so how the fuck can you expect a game to expand? Even if you like, even if you enjoy it, even if you like it, if you're not actively playing. You know, there are so many people that you see like, oh yeah, UNIEL, I love UNIEL, it's an awesome game, I absolutely love playing it, it's fantastic, it was wonderful. Oh, you still playing it? Oh no, I moved on to Guilty Gear, or whatever. And so it's a very simple fact that the anime games are not going to really get any, it's perpetuated too by the companies behind it, like this isn't entirely a player-based issue. If the companies would just, like with Street Fighter, how every single version expands on its past version. You don't need to buy a new disc. You don't need to, you know, what, blah, 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 whatever. Who gives a shit about all that? But how it's always, the community doesn't get divided by a bunch of different games. And yet, that's all that happens with the anime games. And so who gives a shit if all the anime games have a community of like 5 billion people when there's 4 billion games and there's only one person playing each of them? It's definitely a source of irritation when it comes to anime games for me. That like if you don't import it, you're not going to have a lively, active community. You're going to be stuck with basically like a very small fraction. Oh, I tried to assault over that. Oh, he has a dodge? I didn't know that. Maybe that didn't hit. Oh, I tried to. Oh, I tried to 5A that. Or 2A that. I tried to anti-air that. Huh. Really? You can chain shift and counter throw? Yo, where? It's getting irritating now. I did not want that, but we got it. I need to stop going into that. The fuck! Nate's getting mad. That didn't hit? Okay. Cool. I did it. All right, I need to stop playing like absolute shit, because I'm playing like absolute shit. I need to stop trying to do JC to anti-air. Why? I mean, not anti-air. Need to stop trying to use JC to air to air. Damn it. Oh, okay. What the fuck? I tried to CP. I don't know why my shit just doesn't want to come out ever. I should. That was so obvious. What else are you gonna go for? Damn, my Nanase sucks. And now I'm stuck in another four-player lobby that I don't want to fucking beat, dude. Ah! I want to play. I want to improve. I don't want to fucking have a one and done. Like, I should not have lost to that person. Like, that was terrible on my part. But I don't. It's so fucking irritating. And it's like, yo, run it back. Nope, you don't get to. Too bad. And see all of these. Four, five. I get nothing. I get no options. And this shit never actually wants to. Like, sometimes it'll pop up. Okay, so it's all zeros. Great. I hate everything. I'm just gonna try. I'm just gonna create a room. I'm not gonna stay here. Because it would be absolutely goddamn stupid for me to hang around here. And, like, because I guarantee you nobody's gonna join this shit. We'll see. I mean, if you see a video after this, if I end up posting another video, some one-on-one, where I actually finally get to play, I don't have to sit around and wait for a rotation to get back to me because I don't know matchups, so I can't win 100 goddamn percent of the time. But yeah, this is by far the biggest feature that causes me to quit games. It's why I stopped playing BlazBlue. It's why I stopped playing Persona 4 Arena. Even though, like, I didn't really like Persona 4 Arena, I would have kept playing it if matches were easily available where I could actively play, where I wasn't stuck just watching other people constantly. But that's all that it is, inevitably. And I've never put in enough time. This is a game where I want to actually put in enough time to be the kind of person that can, you know, fight and win 20 times in a row against a full lobby of people. 100% I would like to get to that level. But this game doesn't, again, because people move on past anime games so quickly, they just play them for 2 months and they move on to whatever new one comes out because Arc System Works is... Oh, I'm not gonna get into it. It's not. There's no point in it. But like I said, this is a game that I want to play and I want to get good at. But I clearly hopped on the train too goddamn late, and everybody got off fucking 5 stops ago, and I'm left in a ghost town where the only people that left are the people that, like, are stuck on the train. They don't have any way off, and there's just not enough people left around to support the kind of community that you need to, like, learn and improve. And even then, like, I'm still seeing, like, I have never seen anybody that seemed like the kind of person that was gonna come up. They were either the kind of person that were just like, they're probably an anime fan, so they picked this game up, because it's an anime game and it looked unique and people said good things about it, but they have no idea how to play fighting games. Or they got 3,000 plus played games and they're just blowing all the scrubs up that like picked up the American release. And then that's another problem with it too, is you come into something and you get annihilated like that Merkava player was doing to that lobby. A lot of people are just going to straight up quit on that. It's not a terribly bad thing, because it's unlikely that somebody that would quit at the drop of a hat like that was going to stick around for the long term to begin with. But it's still like, you have this person that is so significantly more experienced in everything. They're not going to, and then you're just going to get blown up and you feel like you had no answer to it. It's just, there's nothing really about this game that makes me want to continue playing it. Aside from, like, I actually enjoy this game. But there's nobody really to be able to, there's no way for me to play it so I can actually truly improve. Because you don't improve when you play one match, and then if you lose, you get cycled to the end and have to wait for three or four other matches in order to get your turn again. You don't improve that way. You will never improve that way. You need to be able to rotate out what you're trying to do against the same person to see what works, what doesn't, what can you improve, what can you not improve, blah, blah, blah. You can't do that in an environment like this. And I was actually... One second. I was definitely considering going to NorCal Dogfight. Let me actually check this out. I want to see. Since obviously I am not in any hurry, I'm not going to be getting any matches anytime soon. I want to see what games the other NorCal tournament supports, because I was going to go to NorCal Dogfight, but then I looked at their game list and saw that all they have is... I can't even remember. Let me see. Oh, actually, right here. The fuck is AP? I don't even know what these games are. GGXR, which obviously I know. UNIEL, which obviously I know. And then AP and EXVSFB. I don't have a fucking clue what either of those are. But anyway, so like I said, I looked at the game list and I was like, oh, they don't have Blaze Blue. They don't have Persona. Like, how are you gonna have an anime tournament and not include the game that's at EVO? But whatever. So like, the fact that they didn't have Blaze Blue or Persona, I was like, okay, well, I'm not gonna go just to get my ass bodied in UNIEL. That's not worth it. So I want to find... Ah, here we go. Okay, so it looks like California Burst does have it. Shit, they got CVS 2 too. I'd go and just mash in that game. Why not? I don't even know what any of the meter stuff does, what the grooves do. I'd still mash it out just for funsies. But yeah, see, like, California Burst has Persona 4 Arena, Exard, and UNIEL. And so, I mean, I don't know. I wouldn't join Exard because I obviously have not put time into that game. But I would join Persona 4 Arena just for shits and giggles, because I'm semi-competent at that game. I can at least, you know, like, not just mash. I know at least some things. But yeah, I don't know how strong the NorCal community actually is. Like, I don't know how many. Let me check and see. Maybe they have... Oops. Maybe they have, like, a results thing from NorCal Dogfight so I can see how many people hopped into that match. Doesn't look like anybody's posted results yet. So yeah, like, I don't know how many people actually go out to it. For all I know, it could be like 5 people. But even then, like, just grinding out casuals against 5 people is gonna help a hell of a lot more than me sitting here talking to nobody and hoping beyond hope that somebody joins my fucking 2-player lobby. But nobody ever will. It is there. I have not once had somebody hop into a 2-player lobby, despite I've probably sat here and, like I said, done various things that I will be writing, like, code for something, doing homework, playing the DS, doing something, anything else, while this just sits here. And there has probably been, like, maybe an hour and a half to 2 hours of just completely idle time sitting here in my created 2-person lobby that nobody has ever joined. Not once has anybody ever joined this lobby. And... what are you gonna do? Like, there's nothing I can do about it. See, like, I'm already done. I'm already sitting here. And the biggest reason right now for it is, like, yo, I could be doing some, I could be recording something else. I could do Marvel. I could be recording Bloodborne. This is my time that I have to record shit. And fuck it. It's very irritating. We got Seth.
Seth.
Nice spacing, Nate. Oh, damn, this is laggy. What am I doing? What am I doing? The lag is ruining my day! I'm not even gonna try to do anything even moderately complicated here. Oh, okay. Wanna fucking reversal me? You don't reversal me? That didn't work. What the hell? I don't know what the fuck is going on. I know it's no good though. Damn, man, I cannot. This connection is bad. This connection is bad. I guess I should have trusted, like, the fact that, dude, this dude turned on something. Wish you would. I pressed a button, like, a second before that shit came out, and then I blocked and then got hit. That was not intentional. Dude, this sucks. I got nothing good to say about this shit. Can I? God damn! As you can tell, I'm super happy that I bothered to try to find a match when it ends up being like this. Awesome! Dude, fuck my life. Okay, glad we can end on that note.